Hello, my 4B friends. Happy asynchronous day. So this month, February, and also really next month too, we are really going to be diving in to nonfiction, whether it's reading nonfiction or writing nonfiction. So teaching someone how to do something or writing what you learned about something, someone, you know, some animal. Whatever we are going to be talking about, it's going to be nonfiction, and you need to have up in that little head of yours an understanding of what is nonfiction. We talked a little bit about it in Journeys, the difference between fiction, nonfiction, informational texts, but let me show you a little bit more because you have this packet. I sent it home with you. It's called My Nonfiction Text Features. Woohoo! A text feature is a fancy way to say something that shows up in a lot of these types of books. So a feature of maybe a fairy tale would be they always start with once upon a time, right? Well, in this packet, you are going to be doing it this week, next week. We're going to be working in this packet and finding examples in the books we read in real life or on the computer, these text features. Things that show up in a bunch of nonfiction stories or nonfiction books. So let me show you the difference between fiction and nonfiction. So here I have a little like poster that I could show you of how fiction and nonfiction, even though they sound similar, they mean two different things. So fiction is stories that have made up characters and events. It didn't really happen. Fiction, fake. Now it might be about, you know, real life things, like it might be about sharks, or it might be about school, or it might be about space. But if it's fiction, that means it's not a real story. It didn't happen in real life, and it might not be trying to teach you anything that's new to you or right. Whereas nonfiction is a real book that talks about real people or real things, and it's trying to teach you something. So when we were learning about the ocean, we read a fiction story called Not Quite Narwhal, but we also read a nonfiction story called Sharks. What if sharks disappeared? So the nonfiction story about the sharks and if they disappeared, that was teaching us about how important they are. But Not Quite Narwhal was just a fun little story that showed us a unicorn and how it, by mistake, was living in the ocean. So that's the difference between fiction and nonfiction. In nonfiction stories, they're trying to teach you something. So maybe you like reading stories like this one about a caterpillar, but if you want to learn more about something or someone, like you wanted to really know about caterpillars and butterflies and how they work, you would read a nonfiction story or an informational text. Informational text teaches you information. So whether it's a story about an animal or it's a biography about a person, you should be wondering, what are you learning when reading an informational story? In this case, it'd be butterflies. In this case, it's lions. There are a lot of different parts that you're going to be learning about when reading informational texts or nonfiction stories. And today I'm going to show you on Epic, a book that I've actually sent you about a very famous African-American that we might hopefully get more time to talk about during our Black History Month lessons. But on the off chance we don't, I'm happy I picked this book for you. And I'll show you exactly how to use your packet and those eyeballs to search for nonfiction text features. Let me show you the ones that I want to learn today. So there's two very important non-text features, headings and table of contents. Can you say that? Table, like a table, of contents. If you ever had a bag, like I have my wallet here, contents means what's inside of your bag. So I have chapstick inside, or I have contacts for my glasses, or I have money inside. These are called contents. So the table of contents in a book is telling you what all the different chapters are, or where to look in the book. Get it? I like that rhyme. So a table of contents tells you where to look in a book if you want to learn about something. So I have this little lion book here, and I have my packet, which you can pause this video and go get your packet. You don't need it exactly just yet. But in this lion book, if I were to flip it open, right at the beginning of the book, I see those same words, table of contents. Now, it's not talking about a baggie and what's inside of the baggie. It's talking about the book and the chapters. There's a chapter called What Am I? Chapter called Big Cats. Ooh, a chapter about cubs, like a baby. There's a chapter about lion talk and how lions roar. So if I wanted to learn just about lion cubs, I could go here to this chapter. And it even tells me, boom, what page to look, where to look in the book. I can learn about lion cubs on page 22. Let's see if that's right. Ooh, 32, 26, 24, 23, 20. Oh, look, cubs on page 22. I know you can barely see it, but there it is. There it is. Focus. There it is. Page 22. And here in the table of contents, it had told me that page 22 was where I could look. I didn't have to read all of these pages. I was able to just boom, jump to the page I needed to go. And that's why if you're reading a nonfiction book, it's really important that you know how to read the table of contents. Because nonfiction books have a lot of words and a lot of pictures, and they're teaching you a lot of things. So it can be nice to use a table of contents to quickly flip through a book to find the page you're trying to get to. You today are going to be in your packet finding an example of a table of contents. Now, don't worry, I sent you a book on a very famous African-American musician, Ella Fitzgerald, and in this book, I made sure that there was an example of a table of contents. It's just up to you to find it. But before we can go and look for that, let me write in my notebook what I found in my book here. So in this little packet or notebook or journal, whatever you want to call it, I have room for you to write examples of what you found. Oh, let me first put my name, Miss Remitz. Maybe I'll put a smiley face, and a little hand, hello. So when you flip open your book, it'll tell you what to look for. So here it's telling me to look for a table of contents. A table of contents helps me find my way around a book. It tells me what different topics, so like chapters, are in the book and what pages they are on. Yeah, remember that? In my book here, there was the table of contents, and I could find the page about the cubs on page 22. Down here, I want you to write the title of the book that you were able to find an example of this. So for me, I read the book Lions. So I would say my title is Lions. And then in this big white space, you can write example of what you found. So it said table of contents. I'm going to make my page. I'll look like this. There we go. So it said, what am I? Then it had some dots here. Then it said on page 4, I could find that. Then it had a chapter for big cats, page 6. You don't have to write the entire table of contents. Oh my gosh, that would be insane. But write some of the examples that you found in your book. If you want, you can even color it too. I'll do one more. Lion around. Oh, get it? It's probably talking about how they like to sleep. Page 10. Nice. So this is an example of a book that would have this nonfiction text feature, this part of nonfiction books, the table of contents. I found it at the front of my book. It'll always be at the front. That way it'll tell you where to look in the book so you can find your pages nice and quick. First graders, I have one more nonfiction text feature that I want to teach you today. So we already talked about the table of contents, and I even found one in my book, Lions, where to look in the book. That's what it taught me. Well, there's another very important thing that you can find in nonfiction books. It's called a heading. Now, point to your head. Your head, is it on the top of your body or on the bottom of your body? Think about that. A head is on the top of a body. So knowing that the head is on the top of your body, a heading, do you think that's on the top of a page or at the bottom of the page? It's just like your body, right? Heads on the top of the page. So the heading, or heads on the top of the body. So the heading is on the top of the page. A heading tells you what the page or the chapter is going to be about. So when you're reading, you'll see a heading is probably going to be in big letters, big, maybe colorful. It'll be at the top of the page and it'll say what the story is going to be about. Like maybe cookies. So if I were to keep reading, I know this whole page is going to be about cookies. Now, obviously a book's not going to have heading as the heading. Let's jump into my lion book and see if we can find an example of a heading. A heading, remember, it's at the top of the page and it tells you what the page is going to be about. It could be a chapter title too. So I'll put my notebook off to the side. We're going to look for an example in our books in a second. So if I'm reading lions, I already saw my table of contents. I remember wanting to read about babies and baby lions. So let's go to the chapter called Cubs on page 22. Here it is. Oh, look how cute. Do you see an example of a heading on this page? Don't smudge your computer, but if you want, you can point to it. It's about cubs. This whole chapter is about cubs, right? And I see big words at the top of the page that kind of look different than all the other ones. They're white, orange, blue, and yellow. It's telling me that this whole page is going to be about cubs. If I were to turn the page, yep, it's still talking about babies. If I were to turn the page, oh, I see a new heading up at the top. So it seems like these two pages and these two pages must be the only part of the cubs chapter. That's the nice thing about headings. You know when the chapter is moving on to another one. So if I had my nonfiction text feature notebook, I would flip to the next page. First, I did tables of contents. Now I'm looking for headings. Headings help me know what topic I'm going to read about. It tells me what the page or paragraph will be about. I found an example of a heading in the book. Oops, gotta get my cover. There we go. Lions. Lions. Nice. And I can do an example of my heading here. So my heading was called, Cubs. So I would write my example here. So it was called Cubs. Maybe I'll try and do the fun writing as it did. Ooh. Cubs. Baby lions are called cubs. If you want, you can try and write more, especially me. I know I write small, so I have more space here. But if you're a big writer and you already took up some space just writing your heading, maybe you'll only be able to write a sentence. But you're showing me an example of a heading that you found. Hey, maybe I'll even write the page while I'm at it. That way I can always remember. Today, you are going to be looking for your headings and your table of contents in the book that I've assigned you on Epic. So let me show you where to go on Epic to find this book. Just in case you're having trouble remembering where Epic is, it's at the top of the page in our classwork, 4B links. We have Happy Numbers, Raz Kids, Epic. There it is. If you ever forget the code to getting into our class on Epic, or your computer doesn't remember it, it's right, It's right here, PVZ1418. You can always just type that in or ask an adult to help you. And away you go. So if I click on this, it'll bring me to the Epic page. My computer already remembers that I'm in Ms. Remitz's class, but you could type the code here, PVZ1418, and click go. But if you have it here already, you might as well just click that. And it'll ask you to sign in to your page. So I'll sign in as guest. If you go up here, you'll see something called a mailbox, and it'll tell you that Ms. Remitz has assigned a book for you to read. Now, because this is a fake account, I don't really have it up here, but you can see that these are all examples of books that Ms. Remitz might have sent you to try reading. So let me show you what the book is going to look like, since yours is going to look a bit different than mine, since this is a fake student account. Okay, so here is an example of what it would look like. When you're jumping in, it'll tell you that Ms. Remitz has assigned a book to you. And if you don't see it, you can always look up in the mailbox that I had mentioned before, because maybe you haven't been on Epic in a while, so you have a bunch of books from me. But if it does show up, it should just have this blue button, Start My Assignment. And you can click on that and it'll bring you to the book. So the book is called Ella Fitzgerald, American Jazz Singer. So Ella Fitzgerald was a famous musician. She was a singer and she has this wonderful voice. So maybe I'll put on some of her music as I'm showing you this book. So this book, you can have it read it to you because it is a little hard to read it on your own. If you want, you can ask an adult to read it with you though, if you want to take turns reading the story, but it does have some hard words, so it's okay if you have it read it to you. But we're going to learn about this famous jazz singer. Remember when Ms. Remitz came back from New Orleans, I read a book to you and talked to you about jazz during music week? Well, she's an example of a singer who likes jazz music. So here we go. Oh, already I see on the first page, table of contents. It tells you where to look in the book. We can read about her birth and her early life. We can read about when she passed away. We can see about when she was famous, and it tells us what pages we can look there. Look to get it, to learn about her. So then it starts having the story about Ella Fitzgerald and tells you about where she lived and what she did. And I'm noticing that I see some big words up at the top here, and they're in a different color, and they're separated from the rest of the story. Let's see if that happened. Yeah, look, it happened again here. Huh, and then here again. So if you're reading about her, you might see some of these big letters. Remember that what that's called? That's called a heading. A heading is at the top of the page and it kind of stands out a little different than the other words. And this example in this book, so this chapter is all about fame, how Ella Fitzgerald was famous. Whereas this chapter is about the Apollo. The Apollo is a very famous theater that she sang and performed at. So in your nonfiction text features, just like how I did it with my book Lions, I want you to read about Ella Fitzgerald and write down the example of a table of contents and write down an example of a heading. So don't forget though, if you want to write the title of the book, just kind of how I have Lions here, you can always flip back to the beginning, Ella Fitzgerald, American Jazz Singer, or you can just call it Ella Fitzgerald, or you can always click up here on this little blue arrow and it'll tell you what the book is called. Well, first graders, that is our first shot looking at the nonfiction text features. So I want you to practice your table of contents and your heading and look for them in the Ella Fitzgerald book. All right, I will see you this afternoon. And I hope you have a good rest of your day. Bye.